Hey girlies, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hey, welcome to my channel. I'm so happy you're here. So for today's video, I wanted to give you guys a makeup tutorial of all affordable makeup. You heard me right. All of these products are going to be $20 and under. That's crazy. I came up with this beautiful, beautiful eye look. My foundation and everything looks flawless. And all of this stuff you can find at the drugstore, at Walmart, or at Ulta in the drugstore section. So, if you guys want to see how to achieve a beautiful look like this using only affordable makeup, then make sure that you hit the like button down below so that I know that you like videos like this. Subscribe before you leave because you don't want to miss out on videos. And hit the little notification bell so you can be notified every time I upload content. It's every Wednesday and Saturday, and yeah, you guys don't want to miss out. So if you want to see how I got this beautiful makeup look right here, then just keep on watching. So we are just going to jump right in and get started. I always start with my eyes first just because there's always a little bit of fallout and I touch my face a lot while I'm applying my eyeshadow. So I always like to do that first just so I don't mess anything else up. To start out, we are going to use the ColourPop Dream Street Kathleen Lights eyeshadow palette. It's very pretty, it's very affordable. So my eyes are already primed and I'm just going to jump right in and get started. I'm going to start out with this color right here. And we're just going to buff that into the crease. I like this palette a lot because the eyeshadows are very blendable and they have really good pigment. I'm also going to try and use all like affordable makeup brushes. So this is the Morphe M441. It's just a big blender brush. So the next color that I want to go in with is this color right here. It's just a deeper color and I'm going to put that in the crease and a little bit on the outer corner just to deepen everything up. And for that, I'm going to be using a Morphe M433. For the next color, I want to go in with this pinky shade right here. I'm going to use that same Morphe M433 brush, and I'm going to pack that on the outer corner a little bit on the lid, kind of where we put the other shade. This is just going to make everything a tiny bit more colorful, a little more summery. Okay, so once that is blended out, we are going to go in with an even deeper color just to deepen out the outer corner and make it a little more smoky, a little more sultry. We are going to go in with this deeper brown shade right here. And we are going to take that on a smaller brush. This is the Morphe M506. It's just like a really small like blender brush. We are going to dip barely any in that because we don't want to get too much pigment because we don't want a color explosion all over our eye because it will ruin everything. Go in with a super, super light hand. So next we are just going to be cutting the crease or cutting the lid just to define it a little more. We're going to be using the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer in the shade C2. We're just going to put a little bit on the back of my hand. We're going to use a Morphe M421 brush. It's just like a flat little shader brush. And we're going to cut the lid. So once we have that cut, we are just going to go back in with our Morphe M433 and blend out the harsh line because we don't want like a rough edge. We want it to be blended seamlessly. Okay, and so for the lid color, I really want to go in with this color. It's kind of like a duochrome, like gold pinky shade. It's really, really pretty. And I think it would look great with this eye look. I'm just going to use my finger because that's how I usually do it. Just start packing it. Oh yeah, that's pretty. On the lid. So once you have that down, it should look a little something like this. And it is now time to apply the false lashes because no look is complete without false lashes. We are going to use the Kiss Lash Couture Faux Mink Collection in Gala, however you say it. They're very pretty. I like them a lot. And they're super, super affordable. Before we apply lashes, we are going to apply a thin layer of mascara. We are going to be using the Maybelline Total Temptation Mascara. I use it a lot. As you can tell, it is very dirty. So now that the eyelash is on, I'm going to do the other eye off of camera and I will be back to do the rest of my face. Okay, so the eyes are done. It is time to move on to the face. So since we are using all affordable products, to start off, we obviously have to prime the skin, get rid of these pores, get rid of my redness, all of that. So to start off, we are going to use the Maybelline Master Prime by Face Studio Blur and Smooth 100. This stuff is kind of like a lotion. You really just need like probably like a pea-sized amount, nothing more than this. You are just going to rub this wherever you feel like you get the biggest pores. So mine is going to be in my T-zone, right around my nose, and up on my forehead, and a little bit on my chin. This is just going to fill in your pores and make your foundation apply flawlessly. While we let that sink into the skin, we are going to pick up the foundation. I'm using my favorite drugstore foundation today. This is the Maybelline Superstay. This stuff is so full coverage. It covers literally everything. I could not sleep for 4 days and this would cover it. So I just use probably a couple of pumps. If I need to go in with more, I will, but I usually don't. And to blend everything out, we are going to use my Morphe contour sponge. This one is disgusting. I need a new one. Don't judge me. So we're just going to put that on the beauty blender and just start blending it out on my skin. So next is concealer. This is probably one of my favorite concealers in the entire world. This is a dupe for Tarte Shape Tape. It is fantastic and it is literally $7. This is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define. This stuff is so nice. It's so full coverage. It's fantastic. This is in the shade C2. We are just going to put this where we would normally highlight. Just go back in with that beauty blender and blend everything out. So once that is blended out and we are looking pastier than ever, we are going to go in with powder because we just put all of this cream on my face and liquid on my face and we need to set it because I don't want to get gross and creasy. So a really, really good powder that I love a lot is the Maybelline Fit Me Powder in 05. This is in the shade Fair because like I said, I am pasty. This is a really nice loose setting powder. It really gets the job done and I'm pretty sure it's like $5 or $6 and you can't beat that. I don't really bake because I have such dry skin that if I bake, when I put too much powder on it, I just look crusty, dusty, musty, rusty, gross. Alright, so still looking pasty and like a ghost, so it is time to go in with bronzer. This is what makes me come to life, guys. I'm using the Morphe Brontour. This is in the shade Celebutante. I'm going to be using my Morphe M527. It is just a big, fluffy bronzer brush. And I just dip in and I just mix these two shades because I really don't contour that often. So, we're just going to warm up my face because I don't want to look like a pasty ghost anymore. So, once we are all bronzed up and we have added a little bit more life to my face, the next step is blush. This, I cannot live without blush. I think it's so pretty and this is by far my favorite blush I've ever used in my entire life. It is Flower Beauty and this is in the shade Peach Primrose. Next is my absolute favorite part, and that is highlighter. Now, this highlighter is from Maybelline. It is probably one of my favorite highlighters in the world. Maybelline Master Chrome Highlighter, and it's so pretty, as you can tell. It's very well loved. I've used it a lot. Now I'm going in with my Morphe. The numbers are worn off because I use this so much. Next is the lower lash line, and I'm honestly not going to do anything too crazy. I'm just going to use all the colors that I used in my crease on my lower lash line. So I'm going to do that off of camera, and I will be back to do my lips and setting spray, and we'll be done. So we have the lower lash line on, we have mascara, I popped that highlighter on my inner corner and on my brow bone. It is now time for lips. This is one of my all-time favorite lipsticks right now. It is Flower Beauty Peachy Nude. Last and final step is going to be setting spray. My favorite setting spray at the moment is the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. It looks just like this. It kind of sprays out like a hairspray, and I think that's super nice because I don't have to worry about getting all those like little dots on my face and going in with the beauty blender and blending it all out. Look, I think it turned out great with all of these products being super affordable. Like, I still was able to come up with a beautiful, beautiful makeup look. I think that my foundation, my blush, my bronzer, all of that looks flawless. And the fact that I didn't have to break the bank to achieve something like this is awesome. Like, affordable makeup products, drugstore makeup products, they are winning. Literally, like, being able to just go to the drugstore or go to Ulta or go to Walmart and like spend very little money and still be able to achieve a look like this just astonishes me. But I think it's beautiful, and I hope you guys think it's beautiful. And if you like this look, please give this video a big thumbs up. If you want me to do more videos like this, like full face high-end products, full face like one brand products, just leave a comment down below and let me know what you want to see. If you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. I post videos every Wednesday and every Saturday, and you definitely don't want to miss out. So while you're down there subscribing, make sure that you hit the little notification bell right beside it so you can be notified every time I upload content. So I think that's it for this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!